I think it's time to change the tone, wouldn't you? Practicing again as a homeroom teacher. I try to be as productive as possible, creating tests for next week's midterm, making a worksheet for the one class I had today, and of course, enjoying lunch. But the day was over really quick, which I guess for a Friday isn't bad. Matter of fact, gave me time to study, and that's always a good thing considering my Japanese level is certainly lacking. Alright, so finally the weekend, and I'm recovered from that migraine from yesterday, which really sucked. Today, not much planned. I have a picnic brunch, and then I have maybe the movies. I don't know. Depends on what's playing. Movies are expensive here, but movies are my favorite thing. It's how I escape. So if there is a movie to see, I want to see it. If not, I'll just go to some place and like in Tokyo and walk around, take some shots. You know, pretty video. Anyway, let me go hit this gym. Show you shots of that for vanity. Yeah, get the day started. For those of you who've been watching for a while, thanks for that. I was doing that hard 75 thing, but it did not fit my lifestyle, so I kind of just switched it up to one body part a day, plus abs. Always abs. Gotta get rid of this fat belly. Look at me having a moment of pure vanity. You fat piece of Anyway, I'm headed to Hikarigaoka Park up in Itabashi. It's a peaceful place that is actually pretty big, so I could actually lay out and relax. Let's check it out. Is it a Tokyo vlog without this video? Yeah, I didn't really think so. I walked all the way over to Harajuku from Shibuya so that I could head to the Apple store to get a new headset. And, of course, enjoy the night view before heading to my favorite restaurant and enjoying barbecue. You're gonna see a lot of barbecue this video. Just, you know, don't judge me. I'm in the gym, guys, okay? I can eat like this. My night ended at Bill's, which, yes, it's a breakfast spot. Yes, I know it's not breakfast time. Please stop judging me so much in this video. Anyway, I came here because they have an amazing almond chai, and I thought that what better way to end the night than with chai. I shouldn't have said end because I still need to go to the grocery store to prepare for, you guessed it, barbecue. And for that, I need to pick up a couple of ingredients. Welcome to Dining with Dontae, something like Binging with Babish, but not as good of a cook. Here we have some pork shoulder that was 2,700 yen, which, bust my budget of using 1,000 yen a day for groceries. Anyway, we're going to start by salting and peppering this big slab of meat after I tuck this towel away. Now, after that's all done, I've skipped ahead a little bit, washed my hands because we're clean in this kitchen. I'm going to take this pork and put it into my slow cooker. Now, if you're wondering how I got this very big slow cooker in Japan, I did not get it in Japan. I brought it with me from America. This slow cooker has been with me for, I think, about 10 years now. So thanks, Hamilton Beach. I hope that, you know, someone sees this and they decide to sponsor me from this one time that you see my slow cooker on this freaking video. Yeah, probably not gonna happen. Anyway, let's put this meat inside the slow cooker. Yeah, all nice and delicate. No, we're just gonna throw it in there. Yeah, cool. And we're going to put that on low. Low and slow, as the saying goes, for the rest of the day. While that is getting started, I'm going to make the barbecue sauce. Now, there are tons of barbecue sauces that come from different areas of America, but my favorite is a mustard-based sauce that is from Western Carolina. A little known fact about me is that I used to work at a barbecue restaurant when I was in high school. It's called Little Pigs, Columbia, South Carolina. Definitely check it out if you're around those parts. I don't know if it's extremely popular place to be, but that barbecue restaurant is extremely popular because of this barbecue sauce. Anyway, after I struggle with this mustard, let's go ahead and put some salt, pepper, and this chili garlic pepper that I tend to enjoy into it as well. After that, we're going to add some brown sugar, and I know that I don't have a cup, so I have to put the barbecue sauce in first. I'm an idiot. I really am stupid. This is definitely not Benjamin Babish. Babish, I'm so sorry that I've ruined your style of video. Anyway, so mixing in this barbecue sauce first because I want to make sure I get the color right. I usually do this by color because I know exactly what it's supposed to look like. And here you can see it's now a bright, creamy colored orange, which is actually kind of disgusting now that I think about it. Anyway, once we add the brown sugar in there, and I don't really particularly measure the brown sugar, I do it to taste. And again, going by the color, we need a little bit more barbecue sauce. And yes, the actual restaurant uses measurements. I just do not because I don't have to please anyone but myself. Something to think about. A philosophy for life, maybe. Anyway, so the sauce is complete. I tasted it off screen because I think it's weird for me to taste something on screen. Anyway, I'm putting this in, jarring it for later. I'm certainly not going to use all of this tonight. I'm going to end up using this over the next couple of weeks. So, while that's cooking, I'm going to put in some laundry right now. Laundry. I washed a couple of loads, and I usually use the dryer because, one, it's rainy season, and two, I'm impatient. And after that, while it's drying, I'm gonna go for a run, go to the gym really quick and hit abs, because even though it's rest day slash run day, it's always abs day. And then after that, it's movie time. Talk about the movie in a bit. But I have a lot of clothes, and I really want to do like a vlog about, you know, my clothing selection, but I always like forget to record that in the morning, so I'm left kind of wanting for material as far as that's concerned. But maybe I can just do like a sit down like plan with me, except my plan isn't bullet journaling, it's my wardrobe for the week, because I usually pick it for the week. Maybe I'll do that tonight. Yeah, maybe we can choose what I'm gonna wear for the week tonight. Anyway, let me put this laundry in and get this run. We'll be right back. vanity. Oh, God. Anyway, the movie theater is in Okachimachi, which is, well, it's in Ueno. Like, it says Okachimachi, but this entire area is Ueno. It's actually my favorite thing to do to go to movie theaters in the morning because I feel like I have the rest of the day ahead of me by doing so. Whereas when I go to movie theater at night, I just feel like, well, it's just time to go to bed, and that makes me feel sad, like it's a wasted day. Anyway, the movie that I'm going to see today is Dragon Ball Super Superhero. Yes, there are two supers. The creator forgot that Dragon Ball was called Super now, so he added Superhero, not thinking about the fact that there would be a repetition of Super. I'm repeating myself. Popcorn is my favorite treat. Well, one of my favorite treats. And we're headed to the theater. A special flavor? I love Japan. All right, on the way home, now I'm gonna do a little bit of a review. It was great. I've been a Dragon Ball fan since I was a kid, and yeah, like everybody knows my favorite character is Vegeta, because, you know, he's short, he's strong, he's prideful. I'm 2 out of 3. But yeah, no, like the movie was great. I think that people who are fans of, obviously, who are fans of, you know, Dragon Ball Z will be a fan of this movie, simply because, like, it has a lot of history in it. You know, old Dragon Ball fans and Dragon Ball Z fans will see some Easter eggs from the past. There's a recap for those that don't remember. My memory's bad, so it was great to see it get a little recap in there. And I don't want to get too much into it. I mean, everyone knows the main characters of this are Piccolo and Gohan. And man, oh man, they deliver in this one. And I'm hoping that this is going to be the start of more of the anime. But yeah, I'm not going to nerd out on you guys. It's just, yeah, I like give you my minute to nerd out. It's fantastic. I really enjoyed it. Not the kind of movie that wins an Emmy, but damn it, I'm happy with this, and I guess it goes along with the theme of this whole diary. Anyway, back to my day. I'm icing my knee right now because I ran this morning, and I've been kind of walking around a lot, and yeah, like I'm old, so I gotta ice my knee. I'm gonna ice this knee. I'm gonna do some studying. And then I'm going to go back out because there's a festival that I want to hit. So I'll catch you guys when I go back out. You know what happens when you study laying down? Well, I'm sure you can guess in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Like an idiot. I actually left my camera on this entire time while I was sleeping because I forgot that it was on and I just fell asleep. So apparently it rained for like a solid 30 minutes and now it's not, it's like beautiful outside. Like look up. Nothing. Rainy season, I tell you. All right, I'm on the way to Kuramae. We're gonna go to, I think it's Torigoe Shrine. They're having a festival today. So yeah, cool. Little shrine festival. It's famous for the fact that there's a 4,000-4-ton omikoshi, which is like the thing that they carry. It's like a portable shrine. So super heavy shrine. Usually everyone tries to like help carry it, but you know, corona, so everyone can't help carry it. So hopefully we'll at least get to look at it. And then I'll come home and finish making dinner. That barbecue smelled really good when I left. It looked like it was ready to shred, but I want to give it a little bit more time, make it more juicy, all that jazz. Anyway, let's go.
Thank you.
A stationery shop, you say? Well, don't mind if I do. Actually, I've been to the stationery shop before. I just forgot that it was here. Maybe if I had one of these maps, I would have remembered. Which is really cool. I actually brought one home. And an open pad with a pencil available, so you know what time it is. This shop is known for its different kinds of paper and notebook material. It's also known for pencils and pens, but it really gets its name from the notebooks that you can create here. All of these are books that you can make yourself by choosing the paper, the leather, the binding. It's really cool. I decided to leave a message for anyone who would read this afterwards. You know, just a message that would give someone an existential crisis if they're on the edge. Like, are you happy or are you wearing a mask? And let's be real, most people are wearing a mask, literally and figuratively. I grabbed an apple candy, apple candy in Japanese, and I also grabbed a potato, more on this later, but the toppings are where this really shines. Okay, so I'm returning home. I got what I came for, potato, candy apple. Seeing people happy. I mean, like, there's nothing like festivals. I think, like, the best comparison is, like, a state fair without the rides, or a block party with more people, strangers, all coming to visit the block. It's, like, there's no one way to describe it. So, it's always a really cool experience, and I'm so happy that Corona is subsiding enough for people to feel safe enough to continue these traditions. It's one of my favorite things. And honestly, the potato is one of my favorite foods here, which is crazy, like potatoes, but it's the toppings, you know, it's the toppings. Like I explained when you saw them, so good. Okay, now let me get back. And here I thought we wouldn't get to see the omikoshi. Well, we can see it at a distance. And that's not the 4-ton one. I don't know which one that is, but I headed home. Home sweet home, Ueno. I really chose well when I chose this area. Like, it's amazing. So this is the meats. Oh, back to my binging with Babbage voice, okay. And we're going to take the meat out of the slow cooker. And look at that, it's melting right onto the cutting board. We're not gonna cut it up though. We are going to just get it here, and then we're going to take two forks and we're going to shred it in the bowl. I'll shred it outside of the bowl so you can actually see how easy it is to shred the meat. And it was a lot easier to shred in the bowl. I was kind of surprised. Now, okay, get this out of here. Check it out on the cutting board. This is just easy. Look at that. Man, I am great. And here is the pork with the sauce in it. Has that nice orange color. Give it a little taste so you guys can see me enjoy life. And booyah, it is great. And plated with the potato, the broccoli, the pork, and it is definitely a part of Binging with Babish's Clean Plate Club. I did great. It was great eating. Thank you so much. Gosho sama deshita. All right, well, it's Monday and finishing up the editing. Actually, I'm actually working on lunchtime. I'll finish up the editing. But I appreciate you guys watching. I do enjoy my life here. I think some of my more dramatic pieces have made it seem like I'm absolutely miserable, and it's more like I'm absolutely pensive, and you know, working through depression while also trying to enjoy my life. It's always good to have that introspection. Just probably better not to be too introspective. I hope you guys love the video. Continue to support the channel by subscribing. And it's been a while since I've ended a video like this, but I'm Dontae. This is Dontae Dakara. Until next time. Later.